Hello everybody, this is Mr. Teletron, and this is one of my drawings that I was doing for one of the prize things that I was hosting for this challenge. And this is for Raielono, who won most improvement. This is one of her characters out of like how many characters she had, but this is the one that really like struck out to me and I thought I would have fun doing. So this is the one I picked. And as you can see here, I added the colors and I already drew it, but yeah, I'm adding the colors now and I'm just placing them down to see how they look. And putting on some on the makeup. And the first thing I usually start with is the eyes. It's usually what most people notice first about a drawing. But here I'm kind of failing. And I'm making my sketch layer lighter and adding eyelashes. Yeah, I normally work on the eyes first, but one thing you might notice about this is that I work a lot on one part more than the others, especially the hair on this part, because I got a comment the other day saying that I actually, like, okay, it was from my 30-day, my day 30 redo drawing, and they said that it looked like I spent too much time on the hair, but I actually didn't. It was because I had a lot of strands. Like, lately I've been adding a lot of strands to my drawings. And so I decided in this drawing that I would do something different. But right now you can see me doing the shines and like skin tones. Skin tones are usually hard to do because, like, you know, you have to put in, like, maybe some reds, some yellows, and, like, some dark browns. Like, I've never done a character with this type of skin tone, and it was a little bit difficult for me. But I normally like to, like, put a little shine in the inner of the eye for some reason. Like, I think it makes it stand out more. And I noticed that I drew the lips a little thin here, but later you'll see that they get thicker. And one of the brushes that I was constantly using in here was like a flat squarish brush. And if you haven't already, it's probably a good idea to always like flip your picture horizontally to see how it looks from the other side, because normally when you flip it, it shows your like what looks wrong and like what's off. So I do that a lot, but I don't do it as often in this drawing because like I've seen that was already good. And here, this is when I wasn't doing very well without my sketch, and I really like how, like, if you know me, I really love sketches. I really love the messy look. So this is me trying to work with my sketch layer. And often I normally use about either like one layer, like that's one or two layers, like depending on what I need. But yeah, this is me, like I'm still messing with the face, like I spend too much time with the face. And I'm finally moving on to the hair. But yeah, the reason why I'm doing post commentary is because a friend said it was better than actually listening to music, and it explains a lot more of what a person's doing when they actually explain it. But I don't really have much to talk about, and this is actually I'm really like a shy person. I really don't know what to say, and I stumble over my words a lot. But yeah. I don't know. We'll see how this works. Like, tell me if like I should do this more, or you can't stand my voice. I get that, like, or I don't know. I don't want to hear any comments that I sound like a 14-year-old little girl. But yeah, this is the part where I start working on the hair a lot. I try to make it, like, have that bushy look a little bit, like how I saw in the reference drawing I saw. But, yeah, like, it looks a little flat on some parts. Well, not because, like, I haven't, like, finished, like, shading it and putting shine. Like, I do that all at once with the hair. Like, often I go to one part and work on another one. Like how I do with my food. Like, sometimes, like, when I go to Denny's, I order country fried steak, and then I eat one thing at a time. But, like, and that's what I try to do with my drawings, but often I'll notice something, like, amiss with a part that I just got done with. One thing you might also notice about my art is I saturated it a little bit more, because I do use a lot of muted colors, because it's something that I'm accustomed to picking, like, the colors. But yeah, like, to make it stand out more, like, later on I put the saturation up a little bit. So much hair and me messing with it. But, oh my goodness, this is surely not much to say right now, but you can see, like, I'm going off everywhere, just, like, putting in details, and I'm working on the hair, and then I'm sometimes working on the blouse. Oh my goodness. But yeah, how are your guys' day? Like, do you guys often watch speed painting videos? Is there an artist that you admire watching? Like, I would love to see some of your guys' favorite speed paint videos. And because, like, I really love watching those, but I don't really know that many. And hey, if you have your own, I would love to see them. Or you guys can give me some tips on, like, what I can do better. Like, am I making my videos too fast, or am I making them too slow? But yeah. One thing I really love doing is putting on the makeup on the girls. I guess it's, like, one of my little girly, whatever they're called. But I do love putting the makeup on the girls, because, like, it's like I do different shades of color on the eyes, and then it's just really fun to do. And then here's when I get rid of that ridiculous strand that I'm touching right now. See? I got rid of it right there, because it was a little, like, out of the way and, like, looking a bit strange. But yeah, like, here, I don't know, with the problems with the hair I'm having is just, like, am I really, like, putting too much, like, time into the hair? Like, making it look like I, like, making it look really detailed compared to everything else? Because, like, seriously, that has been bothering me, like, all the time now. Originally, I was going to, like, this is actually my third time drawing this character. My first attempt was, like, in, what's that program called? Painter 11 or something? Coral Painter? Something like that? But yeah, I had her in a dancing pose, and I could not figure out how to work the brushes, like, how I wanted, or, so it just looked like a glop of colors. And I'm working a lot on that hair. Oh, and one thing that you might notice a lot in my videos is that sometimes I scroll in like very close and then I go farther away, but that's because I'm using this my scroll on my tablet and it kind of screws up when I'm trying to it goes in when I want it to go out, so it messes up a lot, and so I have to like get my like point it at the minus button to scroll out, and it's really a big hassle. And one thing I really hate about doing is shine. You might notice that I really don't do a lot of shines in my paintings or any of my drawings because I really hate doing them. Like, I'd rather just have like shade and mid-tones, but yeah, like I really couldn't figure out like which one looked better, so I just decided to add the one on the bottom lip. And yeah, often what I do with the shine shine on like a lot of my pictures is just do the luminosity layer on the painter tool side. This is what I'm using to color right now. But yeah. Speckles. Those were actually fun to do, but it was a little bit annoying that my hand wasn't that steady when I was doing it. And looks like I'm almost done with this, I think. About 3 more minutes. Yeah, adding shade to the flower. Making it look all pretty. And here, I really suck with making backgrounds, so I normally just make them simple. I think here, like, I added green because I wanted it to be, like, very complementary to the character's colors because she's very pinkish and red. So I decided that green would be best to make her stand out the most. Like, I do love using complementary colors a lot. And yeah, I often have to go in like by hand and like draw the background around the character because of like my because of how many few layers I use. And the patterns of the flowers I'm doing there is actually from the part of the flower design I saw on the reference drawing. And it's a lower flower. Like, if I had drawn more, you probably would have seen like one flower on her that had this design. But I thought it would be it'd make a cool background because, yeah, I didn't want to have like an empty background. But yeah, tiny flowers, aren't they pretty? Yeah. This is me again changing the background color, and actually right here, this is where I decided that it would be better to that the outer line art, well, not line art, but like the outer line should be like black and thicker and like more stark, I guess you could say, so that it would stick out more. And this is me messing with the luminosity. Well, yeah, there, I messed with the luminosity, making the green lighter. And yeah, that's basically all I have to say for this video. I guess I'll see you next time on my next one. So, see y'all later.